Tell a story of the banjo?
Yeah. This is a 1903 Windsor Grand Solo. There's a little plaque in the back that has the date. It says the new Windsor. It's not coming out. Well, it's there anyway. And I'm the, I guess you could call me the third or the fourth owner of this banjo. The fellow who bought it new at a shop in Australia, in Sydney, put it in his will that he be buried with it. And his granddaughter promised and then broke the promise. She couldn't do it. Well, he really loved his banjo, and maybe he felt nobody liked the old music. She kept it a while, and then she traded it for a guitar with a fellow from Ireland who lived in Sydney and who played Irish music in the pubs there, and he was an instrument trader. He put it up on eBay, and he told me the story. And I think the old fellow would be really, really glad to hear the old music that he would have played, being played on the banjo now.
Beautiful,
well, it's got beautiful, beautiful inlays on it. Nice rosewood neck, too. Nice old wood.
Yep. You want to show the bridge?
Yeah, the bridge has feet that are sort of semi-hollow. There's a little curve under there. Kind of looks like really looks like a bridge.
Right.
And it has a wonderful sound. Other bridges don't bring out as much sound, as sweet a sound. I have to tune this banjo a little bit lower than pitch, because the fourth peg, for some reason it slips when I get it up to C. I've got it just maybe around B, just a little lower.
So that was the Tantalizer? The Tantalizer, right?
That was the Tantalizer.